Did really good considering what I was saying.
The difference though,
yeah.
See, I misunderstood.
Yeah, I thought that the from what you had said a long time ago,
I was wrong.
Hmm.
I might be wrong about this one too.
Oh, we've seen that one. We've actually seen that thing actually work.
Well, you know, I need to do some more study on it. And I would like to see at some point what would happen if we threw it in 4 o'clock.
Oh,
never
yeah.
Had to. I'm not talking about
no.
Four low.
Yeah, four lock, yeah. I know in the drain goes how that works exactly.
But I mean, the drifts were taller than the fireplace.
And and you were never out of auto,
yeah. Yeah, always in auto.
And you don't have the most aggressive tread on this thing.
No. But we
will. Oh, holy, imagine what that would be when you. If you had those BF Goodrin GTs and these things,
it would be very even more energetic.
Yeah. That would. Which ones do you have on this thing even?
Whatever it came with. Mm. They ain't cheap, I'm sure.
Oh, I'm sure not. Well, the ATs are, what, $200 a tire? Or?
Probably. In this case, you had to buy four of them.
Yeah.
Be crying for a while.
Yeah. So we found out in the Comanche, though, it pays for itself.
Well, it's like night and day difference.
Well, if you have to call a tow truck or something.
Well, no, you don't, unless it breaks down.
Well, yeah, but I mean, if we still had those stinking all-season tires on the thing, we might have.
Well, even with that... Tells you how good the Jeep system is.
Even it is, but boy, you get some of those remote, those section line roads, you're like.
But if we would have had those, no.
Oh God, if we would have had those ATs,
and
we just crawled right out of it.
The steps.
Yeah, those running board step thing.
Yeah,
ugh.
We'd have been fine.
Ugh.
We would have probably never had any problems.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know, please identify.
Well, maybe. On that little section of it.
Yeah,
but, some other part might tell you that. Because I don't think they've gotten around to nicking that off. Because it was on there last night, so.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Yeah, I think 1600 ISO was just on the upper limit of what you should even put on this thing for ISO. I don't even think she should have had that on there. But I watched some of the footage. It was starting to grain out in places. And I was like, a little bit too much noise in certain scenes.
On the
GoPro,
well,
on the Hero 7. Yeah, well, I had it on 1080p at 24 frames, which... should have given you the better the low light because less frames a second. You should have had a little bit more light gathering ability. That's about as much as you're going to get out of it. See, and this thing doesn't have the world's great. Because it only has an f-stop of like 2.8, which is not the greatest for low light.
That's it.
Well, they need to get a better sensor in the thing. Yeah, it's icy.
Yep.
Need to put 1-inch sensor in these stinking things. help. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows? That's our truck. Cool. As you can tell.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Yep.
You gonna take that to work and put it there?
I didn't even think about it, Jeff. I left one in there. Okay, I've got to warm this up. Remind me when we get home to put the chip back in this one, because what I was going to wonderfully do and thought I had figured out again does not work, because I'm going smarter than John.
Yeah.
Which is always a good idea to be smarter than John. Now look at that. Almost. I didn't have the clip on it, so I did there.
There's the only spot, probably.
Hmm?
Probably the only spot.
Yeah, I'm gonna hog the whole thing to myself.
There you go.
Don't worry about the light. There we go. We're back. Now, how do I turn it off? Like that. That's actually pretty handy. Huh. They just showed me how to do that. It's gonna be like over here at 5 o'clock on the road, and they close at 6.
Yeah.
Boy.
Pandemonium.
Hmm?
It'll be pandemonium.
If that lasts.
Surprise, bro.